I was born in Tulsa, and you know, I grew up in Stillwater, grew up in northeastern Oklahoma, graduated high school in 2000, and then went to school in the East Coast in Boston. And after Boston, went to work and make art in New York City for 12 years. And after that, went to the Pacific Northwest for a bit, and then came back to Tulsa, where I've been working here and with the Tulsa Artist Fellowship. So currently I'm in my third year, going into my fourth year, and this is the studio space facilitated by the Tulsa Artist Fellowship. It's a program that's been instituted in Tulsa, Oklahoma, to enrich the community here with artists. It offers a platform for writers and visual artists, and it's in its fifth year, and I'm currently in my going into my fourth year, but I'm in my third year with it. So that's what puts me back in Oklahoma as a working artist, is this program, the Tulsa Artist Fellowship here. So it's allowed me to develop myself, develop my art, develop my understanding of the Oklahoma politics, the landscape of it, all the networking components, and being indigenous here in Oklahoma, and to help, you know, facilitate whatever I can on the platform that I have, because it's a big one. I'm not gonna have it for, you know, forever. It's a short period, but while I have it, I'm definitely trying to fast track a lot of things. You know, I'm not a graphic designer. I'm a painter. You know, I don't really do logos and stuff like that. In fact, I kind of shy away from it, just to not get involved in it. You know, I try to just stick to the brush and application on canvas or wall. I said, well, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make a painting, you know, rather it's not gonna be digital, it's not gonna be, you know, through Photoshop or whatever. It's gonna be a literal painting, and then we're gonna work with a media department here in Tulsa, and then they're gonna take this painting and change it up, digitize it pretty much. And that's what they did, you know, and we came up with something that we thought would work, and that's kind of what became of it. But overall, you know, after talking with the Gathering Place and knowing what they are and who they are, and what they want to bring to the site, and also, you know, the Gathering Place is the initiative on the same lines of the Tulsa Artist Fellowship. We work under the same umbrella here. So it makes sense, you know, this to all be correlating and working together. So my idea through it all is being native from here and being someone who's traveled around the states to a lot of cultural activities, ceremonies, or events. And just as a contemporary native today, that's what we do, we travel. You know, we travel far and wide to go see family. We travel for events, we travel for namings, we travel for ceremonies. You know, that's what we do, you know. We're a people that's been moved from our ancestral homelands to create our own homelands, whether it's reservations given to us by the government or creating our own, you know, areas of living. We have to go back and forth now, you know. It's not just we have this one community. We are dispersed and moving around constantly. So with that in mind, I wanted to create kind of an emblem that makes that journey. And so it's just simple, you know, it was a butterfly. It was simple, but it has my own dynamic of color and movement to it, and it's vibrant, because everything that we do in life as indigenous people is to portray our resilience with vibrancy that we carry, whether that's in the regalia that we wear in our dance, in our ceremonies, in our songs. It has rhythm, just like a butterfly wing does in the wind. Running has been in my life for really, I'd say, 4 years, you know. When I was in my 20s, growing up in New York City, I was a bike messenger, living a wild lifestyle, just like all bike messengers do. I feel like in cities when they're young, you know, you have your own clique, you have your own crew, and you're in Midtown Manhattan, going from Battery Park to Harlem, making that trip about 5 times. You're maybe going 70 miles a day, and you go home to Brooklyn. And then you go out and hang out with your friends to numb yourself from the craziness you've been in all day, and you repeat yourself, you redo it. And plus, just being in New York City for that long and putting yourself out there in that kind of chaos day in and day out, it's just kind of wild, and I think there's an escapism that needs to happen within that. On the flip side of that, I got to see so much of Manhattan that you would never see, that a New Yorker would never see in their lifetime. And the buildings that I've seen, the views that I've seen, the museums that I've seen, the arts that I've seen, working with clients in fashion or boutiques and things like that, you know. So these are inspirations that I utilized in my work as well that ever get me to New York City. But at the same time, I was young, I was in a city, so I was having a good time, you know. It got to a point though where I felt like it wasn't really working for me. I wanted to be healthier too, and I would always come back to Oklahoma in June for our ceremonial dances, the Osage dances, and I would always go back to New York afterwards feeling kind of rejuvenated, you know, feeling like myself again, feeling like, okay, I've been home, I feel refreshed, I can go back to the craziness now, you know, and kind of deal with that and then come back. But after a while, you know, you grow old, and not you don't grow old, but you get older and you think about what's important to you, you know. You shed. You think about what worked and what didn't work, and you get rid of what didn't work, and you try to evolve for the better. You know, not everyone does that, sadly, you know. And so I knew I could, and there are some events in my life and family that led me to make that jump to want to do that, to change totally. Not only for me, but for my family, and for, I think, my people and the people that brought me here. You know, I think my ancestors, everyone who fought hard, you know, to survive, to get my blood here today, you know, I think that'd be selfish of me just to waste that away, partying away somewhere, you know, in New York City, somewhere far away, you know. And it's easy to do, you know, people do it, a lot of Native people do it, you know, and it's, nothing to get sad, because I see what we've been put through, you know. There's a lot of words and memories that are thrown out today, trauma and things like that. Well, that's the truth, and that's, you know, that's real, you know. And it takes strength, and it takes a lot to overcome that. I have my art to overcome that with. Not everyone has that, and I'm fortunate with that. But with that also comes, I think, a responsibility. And I've learned in the past that it's this very strong and powerful responsibility that if I flounder with this thing, it will have an effect on me. It could be detrimental, but if I use it to the full benefit, to empower and to beautify things, to enrich lives, to create resilience, then it gives me strength and it gives people strength. It's a working mechanism I have with art, you know. It's something that I've learned. It's very, very powerful, and it's helped me. And so now, as I'm older, I'm more professional with it. I'm more responsible with it in life and with art and how I perceive the world that I walk on. I'm able to give it all my best and give it all my best to the people to help influence and inspire them. And also to be healthier too. You know, I picked up running, and this is 4 or 5 years ago, and then it became, okay, run 1 mile, run two, run three. Let's get this 5K down from 30 minutes to 25 minutes, from 25 minutes to 20 minutes, from 20 minutes to 18 minutes. And then it's like, okay, let's do like a half marathon, then 50K, 32 miles. Let's do that with speed, then let's do 50 miles, and let's do 60 miles, and then my latest race is 90 miles in the Alps with over 30,000 feet of climbing. And it's been a journey. These things are literally a journey, physically, metaphorically, but they allow me to be expressive with my whole body, the whole truth of who I am as a person. You go through so many trials and tribulations in 30 hours of running, being on your feet, seeing two sunrises, seeing two sunsets, going through all kinds of weather. You go through doubt, you go through anger, but then you think, why am I angry? Where is this coming from? And you figure yourself out on these journeys, but you're also running, it's a race. And then you're accomplished when you finish. And not everyone finishes these things because they are hard. You know, these ultra marathons, they are hard. They take a lot out of you. But if you can do them, you're going to learn a lot about yourself. It's a journey. It takes a lot of training. It's a dedication. Just like painting, it's the same thing. It's a dedication and persistence to it. And they work together. And that is really all I do, is training and painting. And then the professionalism, what comes with that is traveling often, or doing talks, or doing writing about it, or curating, or helping facilitate everything around that. So it's a full-time job. And then training and racing, that's a full-time commitment too, you know, because it's mind, body, and spirit. Cameron Space Studios right here, 303 North Main Street. We offer rotating exhibitions every first Friday here. So whoever's watching, if you're downtown Tulsa on the first Friday, come by Cameron Studios here. Same block as Kane's Ballroom. But we offer this gallery space as a platform for emerging artists or performance pieces or something that, you know, you wouldn't really see in Tulsa, because it's kind of just an alternative space for artists here. It's only been in its first year, so it's still being kind of diced out to how that really operates. And usually we kind of lay the whole year out in January. So, and then we've had a lot of response to people, how can I get in? And so we say, well, you know, we have your name now, so, you know, we'll look at it in January, and I think, and it was just me and two other people, because we, there's three people in the studio right here, and we kind of, you know, pulled out the calendar and looked at, okay, you get this, these 2 months, you get these 2 months, you get these 2 months, and pick out what you want to do, you know. And so it was kind of an internal project, but it's evolved into something bigger now because it has so much, you know, praise, and a lot of people are really into it, and we want to make it more now, so it's kind of evolved. I'm curating a show right now. She's a younger painter, and, you know, this will be her first show, but we've also brought in younger artists before that do this, but, you know, what other gallery or place is going to offer, you know, these younger students an opportunity to have something kind of awesome for themselves? You know, if I remember, I did have a show when I was younger at a coffee shop, but that really was just like amazing for me when I was like 20 or 29. It was like, this is awesome, you know, and it just does wonders for your confidence. Yeah, I just like to give shout outs to, you know, Muskogee Creek Nation, Osage Nation, Cherokee Nation, you know, all the tribes I'm a part of and from here in Oklahoma. You know, I'm happy to be back in Oklahoma working, happy to be painting here and kind of utilizing this platform to kind of do things that haven't been done for the native arts in Oklahoma before, and also help facilitate by bringing in other artists from outside, native artists from other communities, not from Oklahoma, but to help, you know, share their journey and their knowledge and their culture as well. So I think some exciting things will be happening in the next 2 years here for sure. You know, just be sure and come down to Tulsa, Cameron Studios, the first Fridays, and see the open studios, but to come and be a part of it. You know, we want to really kind of make this thing bigger than it is and help a dialogue develop, but we need everyone's support. You know, not only us, we are the ones helping facilitate it, but we need you, the viewers, and people that are into the arts to come out and help share it and help reinvent some new things, so.